In this video, we use the compound interest formula and the compound interest formula where interest is compounded continuously to do the following two problems. We're going to do a practical problem now. All right. A equals P parentheses 1 plus R over N to the NT. That's called the compound interest formula. It's the formula for finding the amount of money A in a bank account if you deposit P dollars at an annual interest rate of R compounded N times a year for T years. Okay. Once we put in some numbers, that'll make more sense. If interest is compounded continuously, in other words, not twice a year, three times a year, four times a year, six times a year, 100 times a year, continuously, it so happens that the formula is A equals P e to the R T. It uses this letter E, which we also use with natural logs. So let's look at an example. Here are the two formulas. All right, let's do this problem. Find the amount of money in an account if $3,000 is deposited at 8% interest rate for 5 years. If the interest is compounded quarterly, and then let's also see what it would be if it was compounded continuously. So I want you to put the video on pause. First, you're going to figure out quarterly. So you're going to look at the compound interest formula up here, and you're going to have to figure out what P, R, N, and T are. Plug it in, use order of operations carefully with your calculator, and come up with that amount. And then I want you to figure out how much money would be in it if interest was compounded continuously using this other formula, A equals P e to the RT. So put the video on pause and try both of those on your own. All right, let's do quarterly first. What do we know? P in both cases is 3,000, right? And the rate is 8%. Now, rate we need to write as a decimal, so 8% is 0.8. So 0.08. I think I said 0.8, but I meant 0.08. And let's see, the time is 5 years for both of them. Time is 5 years for both of them. That's all we need to do part B, but to do part A quarterly, that means how many times a year? Quarterly is 4 times a year, so that's N. N is 4. All right, so if we were going to do the first one, we're going to plug in A equals 1 plus R over N to the NT. I'm sorry, P. I forgot the P in the beginning. And now we plug that in. 3,000 1 plus 0.08 over 4. And then you're going to have to the NT, so that's 4 times 5. So that's going to be to the 20th. And then you need to simplify inside this parentheses. All right, 0.08 over 4 is 0.02, so that's 1.02 to the 20th. So when you put this in your calculator, you need to first do the 1.02 to the 20th power, right? Because you have to do exponents first, and then you're going to multiply by 3,000. That should give you 4,457.84 if you did that correctly. So you put the $3,000 in for 5 years. That's how much money you now have if interest is compounded quarterly. Now let's do it continuously. The formula is A equals P e to the RT. So again, P is still 3,000. We have E to the RT, so we have 0.08 times 5. So that's 3,000 times E to the 0.4, because 0.08 times 5 is 0.4. So to do this in your calculator, you have to do E to the 0.4. So you can put 0.4, and then you use that E to the X button, exponents first, then multiply by 3,000. And this, I'm doing both of these to the nearest cent, will give you 44.75 and 47 cents. Not a huge difference in many, but there is a difference. All right. So if it's only compounded four times a year, you have $4,457 actually almost $58. And if it's compounded continuously, it's $4,475. So not a huge amount over 5 years, but that is the difference. Okay, so that's how we would do that problem. So I'm going to give one for you to try. All right, here are the two formulas again, and here's a problem for you to try. Find the amount of money in an account if $6,000 is deposited at 6% interest rate for 7 years, if interest is compounded. First, let's do it for twice a year, and then we'll do it for continuously. So put the video on pause and try each of those. Okay, for both of them, we've got that P is 6,000. The rate is 6%, 0.06. The number of years, T, is 7. And for part A, we also have to know how many times a year. So N is going to be 2. All right, so for the first one, we would have A equals 6,001 plus 0.06 over 2 to the NT, so that's 2 times 7. So we have 6,000. Now 0.06 over 2 is 0.03, so that's 1.03 to the 14th. And then we're going to put that in our calculator and round it to the nearest penny. First, you have to do the 1.03 to the 14th power and then multiply it by 6,000. Make sure you never round until the end of the problem. So I come up with $9,075.54 when it's rounded. All right, now let's do it continuously. So we're going to have A equals 6,000, right? E to the RT. So 0.06 times 7. So we have 6,000 E to the, so I think that's 4.2. I'm sorry, 0.42, right? 0.42. And remember, we're going to have to do E to the 0.42 first and then multiply by 6,000. And I've got 913177 when you round it. We're talking dollars and cents. So you can see the difference just having it compounded twice a year as opposed to continuously. So here's where you're using the formulas, and what you're really learning how to do is use your calculator very carefully.